Last night it was in some of the establishment prostitute media, the dinosaur media, praising Jim Carrey. I've seen him in interviews. I mean, I think he genuinely is mentally ill. He's kind of a geek. That's why it's funny to watch him. Literally denigrate and in this disgusting 5-minute song, and we're going to go over some of the lyrics to it here today, and it's got some profanity, so we won't play all of it. Say that gun owners, but that Chuck Heston, Charlton Heston, a true humanitarian, a true civil rights activist, a patriot, that he is guilty for dead kids, that he won't be going to heaven, and that he's mentally ill and believes in space aliens. And it was just so ham-fisted and so pathetic, I got angry, and I figured it out last night. I couldn't even go to sleep, folks, and I can go to sleep in like 1 minute. I can just turn my brain off. I was so upset I couldn't go to bed till like 2 in the morning. I shot like 3 videos for the YouTube channel because I realized these people are so pathetic and such liars and such hypocrites with their bodyguards and so anti-individual and so wrong and so authoritarian that I'm angry that we have not routed them out. Now, I called a very busy individual, but he's obviously very angry about what's happening as well. I talked to him this morning on his cell phone, Ted Nugent, who needs no introduction, NRA board member, top rock and roller, patriot, hunter. I called him on his cell phone a couple hours ago, and I said, can you come on about Charlton Heston? I know you were very good friends with him and really got him to get more hardcore on the Second Amendment. He said, absolutely. It was Ted Nugent that helped supercharge Charlton Heston into the fight at many levels. So here is his friend to defend Chuck, Charlton Heston, because he can't do it. He's dead. But again, Charlton Heston will live forever as long as liberty lives. And so understand that, ladies and gentlemen, this is a big deal when people literally desecrate the grave of a man who would do 50-plus interviews a week when he was almost 80 years old and who would travel the country for nothing. No money to defend the Second Amendment. And I knew him. I had a chance to talk to him off air. He was the real deal and probably the classiest person I've ever had the pleasure to get to know a little bit. And I'll be honest, I don't envy many things. I envy Ted Nugent being such good friends with him. Ted, you've got the floor, my friend. You've got the floor. Thank you for coming on TedNugent.com. I know you're about to go on your Black Power tour, and but we appreciate you giving us time today. Sir, you've got the floor.
At you because there's no question that the great American legend and icon, a true warrior, a true hero, Charlton Heston, deserves nothing but respect from thinking, caring, conscientious, educated people. But again, as we talked before about the gift from God that Piers Morgan represents, I mean, God literally sent Piers Morgan from England to try to debate the Second Amendment. So you literally couldn't come up with Alfred E. Newman versus an audition for One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest to come up with a better representative of a guy who hates freedom and hates the Second Amendment and hates Ted Nugent, Alex Jones, and hates the NRA and hates self-defense and hates guns. And I think we are not here so much to defend Charlton Heston because, once again, God has sent a complete brain-dead, soulless punk to desecrate the absolutely well-earned and deserved glowing reputation of the great Charlton Heston. And what Jim Carrey has done, and I've been all over, we have a talk back at TedNugent.com, and we have thousands of people from all around the world that come to celebrate self-evident truth and common sense. You know, the same communication that you get, Alex, from people who understand, you know, history, the evidence that brought us to the greatest experience and the greatest quality of life in America. And when a guy like Jim Carrey pulls off this kind of mean-spirited, soulless, I think the best word to describe Jim Carrey and Piers Morgan and guys like, you know, Michael, I'm still looking for personal hygiene more. They're all one big gaggle of soulless punks. And I would understand, and I understand when a person is uneducated and ignorant and hates America and hates self-defense and doesn't believe in self-defense. But then again, if you examine Michael Moore and his armed security detail, if you examine Jim Carrey and his armed security detail, when you examine Michael Bloomberg and Governor Cuomo and Nancy, you don't have to read this, you need to sign it, Pelosi, and of course our favorite gun runner, Eric Holder, when you examine the freedom haters who because when they open their mouth, yes, we have an unfortunate and a tragic percentage of Americans who are more like sheep than we the people that support these freedom haters. When they speak, common sense America, people who have jobs, people who put their heart and soul into being the best that they can be, people who appreciate the gift of life, the sacred gift of life, and our moral, intellectual, and spiritual obligation to defend that life, and that the Second Amendment was written down to remind us we have the individual God-given right to defend that precious gift of life. Good people understand the pure rot from Jim Carrey. So, in his grave, Alex, let's really examine this. From the grave, the great Charlton Heston represents bait to the Jim Carreys of the world. And I think Charlton Heston, if we could communicate with him, he would be smiling right now. He wouldn't be hurt. He would be smiling because Charlton Heston knew the culture war was coming before any of us did, Alex.
No, he was there sounding, the alarm, and he is just like our forebears fight from the grave for liberty with their statements and the Second Amendment they laid down. Charlton Heston is like an El Cid strapped dead on the horse out there terrifying the enemy.
Yep, and here's the beauty. Charlton Heston would be more than proud to cause much anguish and insanity in the soulless vacuum of Jim Carrey's brain, or his skull. Charlton Heston is like you and I, Alex, only he's better. And he is just giddy with joy that he has inspired Jim Carrey to become even dumber than dumb and to be just this toxic source of indecency and mean spirit and hate. Charlton Heston isn't even alive, and he caused Jim Carrey to expose his soullessness. So don't underestimate in the culture war, more important than the lie of Bowling for Columbine by Michael No Hygiene Moore and Nancy No Soul Pelosi and Diane, I've got a gun, but you don't get to have one, Feinstein. I mean, the list goes on of just hypocritical, brain-dead, subhuman punks. Or, not to mention, Alex, the Vice President of the United States recommending felonies live on TV. You got to be kidding me. Alex, again, if you and I were to sit down with all the greatest minds on earth, the most clever, educated, witty, brilliant minds on earth, we couldn't design an enemy that looks more ridiculous than Nancy Pelosi, Dianne Feinstein, Joe Biden, Barack Obama, Eric Holder, Jim Carrey, Michael Moore, ad nauseum. So yes, it is hurtful, and it does inspire righteous indignation, and we should be angry, but we should also take a deep breath and go, hey, Jim, do it again, because you're distancing yourself further every time you open your imbecilic mouth, surrounded by your armed security details, demanding that the rest of us don't get to have any security. So, Alex, I know it hurts and it's ugly, but you know what? I think in Nuremberg, 1938, we got there late, but when we finally got there, we made those subhuman Nazi brown shirt punks walk through Auschwitz and look what they caused. Look what they did. And this Jim Carrey moment is a mirror that we can show somebody, hopefully soon, that these people enhance crime, they encourage crime, they facilitate and guarantee more innocent dead citizens.
Sure.
Because they're
well, that's it. They know, Ted Nugent joining us, they know crime's dropped 49%, violent crime, FBI statistics since 1991. As the guns go up, the crime goes down. They know that. So it is a criminal instinct of hypocrisy to want to dominate us because they're collectivist. that end up getting our banker bailout money. They are just lawless parasites. Michael Moore, all of them. They know exactly. Dianne Feinstein, she's got her own gun. She's got her own security detail. They have this criminal instinct to disarm us.
Absolutely. Well, I mean, do we need any more evidence than the number one cop in the free world running guns to Mexican drug gangs? Are you kidding me? Again, we couldn't write a Planet of the Apes meets One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest by Alfred E. Newman that's dumber than this scenario.
And they get away with it. That's why I got so mad by the video, and we're going to break here, but I want to get your take on this, that they are so pathetic. That's why it made me so mad. It was nauseating how stupid they are and how ridiculous. But then they're still taking over. There's these idiots everywhere that think that's funny.
Well, number one, Alex, today our job, as always, get everybody within earshot. Join the NRA, increase your membership in the NRA, and here's the most important one. Give NRA memberships to everybody you know. There's certainly a birthday, a graduation, an anniversary, some type of celebration, or just somebody that you admire, or an anti-gunner that you debate. Get them a membership in the NRA. They will read The Armed Citizen in the magazine.
Stay there and make Ted Nugent president pro tem. Stay there. We'll be right back.
I'm Darren McBreen, and these are some of the new items that are available now at InfoWarsShop.com.
Alert the public to Obama's blatant abuse of power with the new Obama t-shirt. Obama's Joker face on the front and Come and Take It on the back. It's time to publicly call him out for what he is, a tyrant. Defend the Second Amendment with our top seller Come and Take It t-shirts. And look at that, women's cut tank tops and t-shirts now available. Nice hat. Plus the Don't Tread on Me flag. And now you can become a micro distributor of the InfoWars magazine. Plus, get your own copy delivered right to your door each and every month. And if you're tired like I am of you and your family being exposed to polluted drinking water, get the Pro One High Performance Water Filter. It gets rid of all pathogenic bacteria, cysts, fluoride, heavy metals, and numerous other contaminants.
So join the revolution at InfoWarsShop.com.
Monday through Friday from 11 a.m. until 2 p.m. Central, we're here live, also on XM 166 and over 150 AM and FM affiliates. I'm Alex Jones, your host. The websites are InfoWars.com and InfoWarsNews.com, where we have InfoWars Nightly News. TedNugent.com is an amazing website and has a lot of just really cutting-edge information on it when it comes to the fight for liberty. And if we can go back to that phone conversation this morning, Ted, again, Ted Nugent with us right now, to the points you were making, because you were so focused. It was really focused anger. And you were talking about the fact this is a war. Because, I mean, these collectivists, they don't want to just go into the Second Amendment. They want to expunge everything. I mean, they are literally taking over. And the problem is so many of the Republicans are part of this as well. I think everybody who loves liberty needs to get really aggressive. So I think it's a change in our guts. And you talked about just knowing we're right, Ted Nugent.
Well, again, the term self-evident truth isn't shouted often enough from the mountaintops of our daily lives, Alex. So we salute you for doing that, and we salute everybody out there. And again, I constantly reference the curse of apathy, the self-inflicted suicide of disconnected sheep in America. But again, only the guilty need to feel guilty. Some guys go, well, I'm not a sheep, I'm involved. Well, then I'm not talking about you, pal. But we know sheep. We all have sheep in our lives. We know someone who shrugs their shoulder and goes, yeah, I believe in the Second Amendment, but there's no reason we should own a machine gun. You know what I mean? We need to take these people and fix them and get rid of the self-inflicted curse of apathy, because the term self-evident truth, what you rail about, the culture war in our face, the fact that a Chicago gangster, a manipulating acorn, communist hanging out with deceitful scam artist Barack Obama has weaseled his way into the White House, if that's not an indicator that too many Americans are sound asleep, then I really don't know what else I can tell you. But we know it to be true, but the answers are not mysterious. The remedy is not mysterious. This isn't rocket scientists. An experiment in self-government is in our guts. It's in our soul. It's the most powerful instinct to pursue your individual happiness, to know that God gave us each an individual right, as outlined succinctly and eloquently, and for the first time in the history of mankind, in the U.S. Constitution, the Bill of Rights, the Declaration of Independence. My God, we've got to communicate this to our elected officials. And again, I'm going to repeat this till I blow up. NRA memberships, there aren't enough of them. The most powerful sucker punch into the solar plexus of the Nancy Pelosi and Feinsteins and Michael Moore and Jim Carreys of the world is numbers. NRA membership.
Exactly, exactly. Just to back you up, Bloomberg has now raised $14 million off the dead kids at Sandy Hook, the victim disarmament zone that he helped nationwide set up. So if anybody's guilty, it's him. He's trying to collectively make us guilty. He raised $14 million to run around and pay off police chiefs and local governments to come out against guns. And we have to take it personal when these people do this. We have to give money to the NRA and Gun Owners of America and your state gun groups. Folks, you've got to give time, energy. You've got to support alternative media platforms, libertarian, true conservative. What about this? What about how Homeland Security is now buying billions of bullets, armored vehicles, and saying the number one terror threat is gun owners, conservatives, libertarians? I mean, talk about Twilight Zone, Outer Limits. We now know that they are taking over Homeland Security as another branch of the military. It's become the fifth branch, trying to point it at us.
The curse of apathy and the political correct scourge of denial. I mean, what you just mentioned, Alex, I'm just a guitar player. I never went to college. I was too busy learning stuff. You know what I mean?
Me too.
I'm a pragmatist. I'm a utilitarian. I cut my own lawn. I change my own oil. I gut my own deer. I butcher my own carcasses. I breed my own wife, and I play my own music. I'm just an independent. I'm a throwback to rugged individualism. And again, I've been clean and sober for 64 years, and if you look at my family, if you look at my incredible wife, if people want to have the time of their life, I don't know what you do, Google Shemaine Nugent Zumba or my band, my crew, my kids, my brothers, my sister, my friends, my production, everybody around
you me. Are electrically alive, just breathing in life, and are successful and dynamic because you're tied in to your God-given instincts, and these collectivists are a bunch of sacks and piles of stinking dog crap. I'm sorry, that's what they are, and they want to make us like them.
They're subhumans. I mean, literally, they're as evil gets, so we can sit here and go, so you're not aware, Mr. Neighbor, Mr. Co-worker, someone at church and school, so you're not aware that the Homeland Security, the TSA, the DHS...
Stay there, Ted Nugent, Ted Nugent, straight ahead, TedNugent.com. He's on fire. Ted Nugent is with us, and the more I get to know Ted Nugent, obviously I've known him for years, he's been coming on the show for probably 15 years, but the more I really get to know him, he is such a patriot, and you notice as things get more hardcore, he gets more hardcore, and I wanted to talk to him about how to beat these people. We're going to get to the fun of guns after we cover the more serious topics in a moment. It's time to get aggressive, 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 and support TedNugent.com. The globalists, the New World Order types, love to act like we're all alone, that we don't have any power, that we're weirdos. At the end of the Charlton Heston demonization video where they say he killed the kids, God hates him, he's going to hell, he's a psycho, he's scum, he blows his foot off. At the end of the attempted defaming that falls flat on its face by the little scrofulous creature, Jim Carrey, and his masters, at the end of the whole video, you realize that these people are just pathetic and that all they've done is give us another tool to show what scum they are. But we are in a culture war. And at the end of the video, they all laugh at Charlton Heston and laugh at gun owners. And you're supposed to feel like you're alone at the end. You're supposed to feel like as there's blood all over Charlton Heston, you're supposed to feel like you're a moron and because this scum laughed at you. That's all peer pressure manipulation. These people are the scum, and they really are the degenerate scum. And it's time to really get in their face and stop being nice about it. I mean, Ted, I think it's time to go all the way. It's time to triple and re-quadruple down. They tell us be nice. That's the way to win arguments. This is our enemy telling us this. What do you say about really getting aggressive, then get into DHS, get into still touring, getting bigger every day, the wake-up that's happening? I want to get into Uncle Ted's advice in this war. Ted Nugent, you've got the floor.
Well, Alex, when you recommend getting more aggressive, surely you've seen the YouTube video of me holding up a bunch of drum-fed AR-15s on stage and telling Nancy Pelosi, then-Senator Barack Obama, Barbara Boxer,
oh, yes,
Dianne Feinstein, et al. To suck on my machine guns. Should I get more aggressive than that?
No, I think, no, I'm telling, I'm not telling you that. I'm telling the public.
I know what you mean, but and we love you madly, but I do believe that I may be the only guy on the planet who's got a couple notches up the aggressive chart from Alex.
Oh, no, let me be clear. I agree with you. I'm telling the audience, I think it's time to get aggressive. What do you say then?
I just thought I'd make sure, if people listening right now to us, Alex, haven't Googled my name lately, get yourself some popcorn and a couple of big gulps.
You're right.
And Google Ted Nugent and watch me drive the liberals berserk.
That's what I do sometimes on Saturday nights. I literally do. Go watch your latest YouTube.
I mean, it's just his. And by the way, Alex, I have, my wife will tell you, I never in my life have woke up in the morning, rubbed my hands together, got a wild eye look in my face and gone, what can I do to drive liberals batty? I've never given it a thought. Swear to God, my instincts
exactly
are to stand up for truth, logic, the logic and pragmatism that brings independent quality of life, and I celebrate and promote those things. I started promoting, never defending. I have never defended the Second Amendment or backstraps. I've never defended anything. I promote and celebrate all good things, self-evident truth, logic, goodwill, decency, and the American way. And I found out as early as 1965, 1966, the beatniks were morphing into the hippies, and they hated me. And I sat back for a minute, and I go, you hate me because I believe in self-defense and I eat venison? Are you kidding me? But here's the bottom line. I would love to get Pelosi and Boxer and Feinstein and Michael Moore and Jim Carrey and Bill Maher and Piers Morgan, I'd like them to get on film and admit, how much dope have you smoking? How many mind altering, and I'm not alleging they have, allegedly they talk and conduct themselves like cesspools of mind altering drugs. And I bet you, if you got everybody that hates Ted Nugent and Alex Jones and the NRA and freedom in America, if you got all of them to take some truth serum and look in the camera and admit how much mind-altering substance abuse they've subjected themselves to for how long, no one would be surprised that they are Timothy Leary run amok. And that's what you can expect from those kind of people. When you have intentionally poisoned and destroyed your brain, you can come out with a video like Jim Carrey has.
Well, let me throw this at you briefly and then get into all those other topics we talked about during the break. Again, Ted Nugent's our guest, if you just tuned in, and he's on fire today after they've tried to desecrate and demonize Charlton Heston. And I believe it will blow up in their face. Buzz Bissinger was on the Piers Morgan show a few days after I was on there, and he said, you know, we ought to get him in here and shoot him. And then the ambassador's daughter, Huntsman's daughter, and Morgan agree and say, yeah, I'll put on a police uniform, and they fetishize that, real creepy, and we'll shoot Alex Jones. And then Buzz Bissinger has now come out and admitted he likes to buy $600,000 a year of women's clothing. And I mean, my whole issue is, what is the point of this? I mean, you know, this guy is, if I said kill him, which I'm not, I mean, that's like going out in the yard and stepping on dog crap. If I said kill him, I would be arrested. He said kill me, and then it's a joke. These people fetishize killing us, and they're constantly talking about killing constitutionalists. There's, you know, there's so many examples of this with people like Alec Baldwin, you name it.
I mean, well, that's why our instinct, you know, and again, if we go back to what made America great, we didn't meet the British punks at Concord Bridge to make them tea and have a discussion. We blew their brains out. That's how you stop tyrants. That's how you stop King George. That's how you stop despots and emperors and punks that want to control your life and oppress freedom. You meet them at Concord Bridge and you blow their damn brains out. That's what we did in 1776 because we'd about had enough. And so when you made that statement on Piers Morgan, I've seen the transcript. All I can say is, hello, self-evident truth, common sense, and history is not up for discussion. It is what it is. But now in the culture war, it is important that we let them talk. We let them threaten our lives. We let them call the greatest, maybe one of the greatest heroes of the civil rights movement, next to Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. and others that sacrificed so much, the freedom marchers and so many. Charlton Heston is the most revered and earned reputation icon and hero, Alex. So let Jim Carrey show his evil side. Let Jim Carrey lie. His entire video is a lie. And these punks like Bill Maher cannot separate their humor license, their creative humor license, from the respect due a great man like Charlton Heston. So it's good that they take the bait, but we, the people, who still understand the foundation of the greatest quality of life in the history of the world is outlined in the Bill of Rights and the U.S. Constitution, the Declaration of Independence, the Ten Commandments, the Golden Rule, those of us that are in the asset column of America, we still are running short of our responsibilities to educate, inspire, and prod everyone in our lives. There's an enormous army that could have won this last election, Alex, if all of us that knew the truth and knew the evidence, if we shared it and we asked and we really pushed harder to get our friends to join the NRA, to communicate with their elected officials, and to speak up. There's still too many sheep in America, and the sheep dogs need to educate them so we can reduce the wolves.
You're right. And in closing on the point of Charlton Heston, before we get into solutions, so many people that support liberty are just quiet and, you know, they're sitting back and they're waiting if the system pushes too much. And as Andrew Jackson said, don't fire till you see the whites of their eyes. You know, I understand the point of let the enemy run amok. That's what's discrediting. Polls show that people are more pro-gun now than they were just 6 months ago.
Sure.
There's a new CBS poll out. They're very upset that their whole hoax has failed. But at the same time, they've still got control of the government and the bureaucracy because they crave the control. How do we really get on the offense as individuals? I say go to city councils. I say get in the face of police chiefs that are anti-gun. I mean, my own police chief in Austin says, you know, turn in your semi-autos, ban high-capacity clips, ban gun shows. You can't buy your son a gun. No private sales. You don't need a semi-auto to protect yourself. Well, then how about the Austin police, who I know most of them are good people? How about you turn in your semi-autos? What a load of bull. What do you say to that?
Well, he's obviously the illegitimate stepchild of Ann Richards. But that still exists. I mean, Sheila Jackson Lee is alive and well in Texas. So we've got anti-freedom. We got hypocrites because I guarantee you that chief of police has a semi-auto to protect his family, Alex. Are you kidding me? Well, again, it's communication. I've been doing this forever. I think I was one of the first guys to find myself face-to-face with the whites of their eyes in the culture war back in the 1960s because the tip of that spear has always been gun rights and hunting rights, private property, hunting, conservation. We, the people, own those resources, not the king. So I got to tell you, I'm going to put out a salute right now to Ranger Tess and Go-Kart and Steve and so many guys at my talkback, Blood Trails. I have thousands and thousands of people, not just from the United States, but Canada, Japan, Australia, Germany, England, Belgium, Sweden. I mean, people from all around the world who dream of, who crave and have the instinct to be independent. free. They come to TedNugent.com TalkBack. And a salute to them, because for every TalkBacker that you and I communicate with, they need to communicate with another dozen. And those dozen need to communicate with another dozen. That's how we win this culture war. We have not turned up the heat. We have not got aggressive enough. But we always have to be on the civil, polite, goodwill and decency side, and let the Jim Carreys spew their venom. Let them expose themselves for the haters and the freedom haters and the America haters that they are. And if we remain civil with the stats and statistics and evidence at our fingertips and at the tip of our tongue, Alex, we will win. That's why I salute you. That's what you're doing. And everybody listening, they don't need to call Alex and say thank you. They need to call everybody else in their lives and get them going.
You're right. Let's get into solutions. Talk about, because you got cut off by the break, the DHS situation. It's admitting there's an armed buildup, that they're trying to create this new domestic security force pointed at the American people. But then I want to hear about the Delta Force and SEALs and people you know. You were telling me off air how incredibly awake they're getting. And then let's talk about solutions. The gun culture they're so afraid of that's spreading, going and literally getting somebody into guns, that one person after another. That's how we're truly going to win.
And you see it happening all across this country. Yeah, it's like your chief of police in Austin, isn't that a heartbreaker? That a Texas law enforcement officer sides with Nancy Pelosi? I mean, are you kidding me? So what did he do? Pee at the wall of the Alamo like Ozzy Osbourne? I'm just heartbroken because I know a bunch of those Austin cops. But here's the final overview. I'm a lucky guy. I get to hang and barbecue and hunt and train with the greatest commando hero warriors that ever lived. I mean, I am so humble, I'm surprised I can even grovel at their feet. Delta Force, Navy SEALs, the Special Ops, the Army Rangers, SWAT commanders, and heroes of law enforcement and military all across this land. I held the hand of Sergeant Todd Balding, who happened to be from Austin, Alex. I held his hand over in Iraq. He took an RPG center mass. I'll try not to cry on your radio show here. He's a young black man, 22 years old. RPG center mass, Alex. It was still in his guts. I stood there in his blood, and I held his hand as he died.
Wow.
I don't need any more inspiration. He died because he swore an oath, Mr. Chief of Police, to enforce, abide by, and fight for, and die for the U.S. Constitution. Do you think I need some punk, some dependent little whiny, soulless, doped-up crybaby like Jim Carrey to give me direction on constitutional and Bill of Rights guaranteed God-given individual rights? Are you kidding me? So everybody close their eyes right now, unless you're driving, and think of Todd Balding as he bled to death and took this giant, ugly RPG rocket right in the guts. And he bled to death fighting for freedom and going after terrorists who attack Americans because of their voodoo, Allah puke, Muslim insanity. And if that's not worth inspiring you to join the NRA, to communicate with your elected officials and do your duty as we the people, then I don't think there's any hope for you, and you probably ought to just move to Canada.
Well, it really is disgusting that these people parade around. In fact, since you mentioned that, and I want to talk about the terror and you know, the culture war, having fun, that is the way to defeat them. Obama says post-Assad Syria of Islamist extremism is nightmare scenario. Obama in Libya, in Syria, I'm not saying Gaddafi or the guy in Syria are good guys, but they weren't offensively doing anything. They're putting real al-Qaeda out of Saudi Arabia over there and are now talking about our troops having to go in after Assad falls to fight them. I mean, what is going on with Obama openly funding real al-Qaeda? I don't know if you've seen the videos of them chopping Christians' heads off in Syria. I can't even believe this. It's like some outer limits or some other dimension that it's in the news. Obama warns Syria could become enclave from extremism. Why is our government offensively with NATO, now saying NATO is over our military. Our military has spoken out against this, by the way. I'm sure you know that.
Sure.
What is going on with that? What are your, do you hear anything from your military sources about this craziness, the 10,000 missiles from Benghazi? Why did they kill the ambassador? They stood down. My inside sources that are in Army intelligence say Obama wanted him dead. It was the Benghazi security force that was al-Qaeda that came over and killed him. I mean, it's just, what is going on with Obama?
I mean, boy, where do you begin to answer that question? Here's a guy that was born to communists, raised by communists, educated by communists, preached to by America-hating communists. I mean, who hasn't studied where this Acorn Chicago gangster scammer came from? But that's what I was talking about, the Department of Homeland Security, which, by the way, Alex, you're on the phone with the czar of Homeland Security. My homeland is secure. Know that. But the domestic agencies, from the IRS to the U.S. Fish and Wildlife to the Bureau of Land Management, U.S. Forest Service, and DEA, and ATF, and FBI, and remember, a lot of those people, I still think the majority of those agents are great patriots and great men and women. And I hang the future of America on the nail of truth that they have expressed to me that they will not enforce illegal anti-constitutional orders from above. That is the great hope. But that they're purchasing all this firepower and armored vehicles, who doesn't know this? Who doesn't identify this as an illegal act by the government who is so corrupt, so out of control? Thank God for Ted Cruz and Rand Paul and Ron Paul and Governor Perry and Greg Abbott and Steve Stockman and Bill Flores and so many patriots that are standing up. And but that's the new GOP that we the people have prodded with the we the people pulse. When you extract the we the people pulse from politics, you will get we the sheeple. I give you Barack Hussein Obama.
I think they're gearing up. What do you think is going on with the bullets? Are they trying to just dry up the bullet supply?
Well, they certainly have succeeded at that. I started my own Ted Nugent line of ammo here last year, and it's like everything else you find on the shelf nowadays, if you can find any. It's state-of-the-art stuff. But we literally can't get my pallets of ammo off the truck. People are buying them in the parking lot before they even get to the shelves. Which, you know, on a consumer side, I'm gleeful of. And the ammo industry, the firearms industry, is literally having a consumer orgy like never before, which is a very powerful statement from we the people that we smell what you're doing, Obama, and we're gearing up too. And a little don't tread on me reminder seems to be appropriate right now. So there's no question what's going on. The deceit, the scam, the criminality, the Benghazi, the Fast and Furious, sending F-16s to Egypt. I mean, you gotta be kidding me. This would make a stupid Burns movie that Alfred Hitchcock wouldn't produce because it's too stupid, but it's actually happening.
But that's what frustrates me. That's why I got so sick. I'm gonna be honest. I came in last night from work, you know, being an evil American. I got home about 9. And she said, "What is wrong with you?" And I just, my kids all came up and they were around me, and 10 down to age 5, and they're, "What's wrong, Dad?" And I just said, "I don't want to talk about it." And then I couldn't, I got so, it was past anger. It was the shame that we allow this scum to walk all over us, and that this country has allowed pathetic filth and authoritarians to even call themselves liberal. Thomas Jefferson was a liberal. They're not liberals. And it just made me reaffirm that I am going to redouble 110%, and I'm coming after these people. Now, what do you think about ways to go after, legally and lawfully, to go after Kerry and all these globalists? How do we really get aggressive? Boycott? What do we do?
Well, you know, I have such a, if you can bear with me, I literally have the answer, the perfect answer. Ted Cruz didn't sprout out of the ground and just show up. I communicated with him. Texans who cared communicated with him. We enthused him. We supported him. Now he represents us. And did you see the beauty, the perfection of we the people when Ted Cruz...
That's threat. We backed him. We backed him. So we take over. And that's what even the Republican establishment is scared of, real constitutional libertarian campaign for liberty people.
Absolutely. But that's why Ted Cruz so riled up Feinstein, because he represented the common sense pulse of logic, freedom-loving Americans. And every state needs to do that. And there's a lot of states that do that. Arizona, South Dakota, certainly Texas is the master of it. Wisconsin has done great things with what they've done with Scott Walker up there. And in his own way, even though Christie's only a solid 2 on the scale of 10, he sure beats the -8 of the past governors of that state in New Jersey. But we the people, where we don't demand representation based on the Constitution and our common sense, where we don't demand it, we will get the Pelosi's and the Feinstein's and the Bloomberg's and the Cuomo's and the subhuman freedom haters that are infesting this corrupt government right now. So the answer is activism, activism, activism. Always polite.
Exactly.
Always firm. But never, ever give up.
Well, here's an example. DrudgeReport.com in the last year has been taking our stories and putting them out about the billion bullets, the 1.6, the 2 billion, the armored vehicles. And they just said it didn't exist, Politico and other White House fronts. Now there's a 15-member congressional investigation starting. Congressman, it's my duty to get to the bottom of massive DHS ammo buy. It's now on Fox, CNN, everywhere. They're being caught lying. And there's an example of just taking action and the people talking to their Congress folks. We're now forcing this issue out. And we can do that everywhere when we just move against them. Tell us about the tour in the last minute and a half and how we win by having fun.
You know, having fun is all things shoot 'em up. I mean, every day in America, American families celebrate the shooting sports and the Second Amendment by spending millions of dollars and shooting millions of rounds of ammo. I mean, that's actually accurate, Alex. American families go out every week and shoot millions of rounds of ammo in training, competition, practice.
And that builds the liberty infrastructure. Listen, you've already done 55 minutes with us. This is a one-minute break. Can you come back and finish that thought for 2 minutes, Ted?
My pleasure.
All right,
pleasure.
Ted Nugent, a little bit of overdrive here, and then we'll continue into the third hour with news, your phone calls, and a ton I haven't gotten to, but he is on fire. TedNugent.com. Insider billionaire investors like George Soros and John Paulson have recently made massive moves into gold, purchasing what Bloomberg News described as gold hoards. Soros alone doubled his holdings in a single day. Russia's Vladimir Putin has doubled down on gold, increasing the country's holdings by over 100%. With $1.8 trillion under management, the bond king, Bill Gross, the world's preeminent bond fund manager at PIMCO, has warned investors of the dangers of QE3 and inflation. And what's he betting on? You guessed it, gold. Friends, this is Alex Jones for MidasResources.com. For more than 15 years, I have exclusively used Midas Resources for all my precious metal needs. Whether it's bullion or collectibles you're looking for, Midas Resources is simply the best. I own my gold as a hedge against inflation. This Federal Reserve fiat currency could go the way of the Deutschmark and the Weimar Republic anytime. In these historically dangerous times, it makes sense to physically hold gold and silver. Midas already has some of the best deals in the industry. But if you give them a call and mention the radio special, they will give you a list of the day's super specials. Midas brokers are standing by to answer all your questions at 800-686-2237. They also have a lot of informative free literature explaining the opportunities and risk of holding precious metals. They are ready to answer your questions at 800-686-2237. Again, that's 800-686-2237. It was 20 years ago, sitting there in local community college, every class, whether it was trigonometry or psychology, hearing how America was bad, guns were bad, George Washington was a piece of garbage, private property was evil, that I said, I got to get in the media. I wasn't even intending that. Went and did an access show, then 6 months into it, got a local radio show, then got a weeknight show, then got syndicated. And I've grown slowly, but now we do reach 15 million people a week one way or another. And it's growing. It's quite frankly scary sometimes. It's an incredible responsibility. But the deeper you get into this fight, it is not work, folks. My problem is I am completely obsessed with it because I'm being assaulted. I'm angry. And I have an instinct to, it's like a fight. If some guy starts a fight and starts kicking your butt, when you start kicking their butt back, you know, you want to go ahead and put them all the way down so they don't get back up. I want to really get on the offense and really go after them. And if everybody would join, state and national gun groups like the NRA and others, if everybody would go to their state houses and get aggressive, we would rout these people. We're, in fact, Ted Nugent, in closing, you're talking about winning and also having fun. Don't you think that they've jumped the shark here, and that if we double down, we can actually have an offense that could really, once and for all, defeat the collectivist?
Yeah, it almost took, in fact, not almost, it has taken this extreme attack on our individual freedoms by Barack Obama and all his gangster punk friends out there to wake a lot of Americans up, buying more firearms, more ammo than ever in recorded history of planet Earth. That's a great sign. But don't underestimate the importance. I use the term cleanse my soul, Alex. I get up in the tree with my bow and arrow, or I train with these heroes of the military that have sacrificed their arms and their legs, and we shoot machine guns from helicopters and kill hogs, and we barbecue and we fish. So never underestimate the importance of getting away from the battle. As long as you've done the battle to the best of your ability and signed up new members of the NRA, Gun Owners of America, you've communicated with your elected officials, and you've kind of educated slash chastised your friends who are not engaged. But then get out with your family, invite some new shooters, take that 22 with ears and eyes and hearing protection and eye protection, and introduce some new shooters. I have a Ted Nugent Camp for Kids charity for 25 years, and we have graduated over 15,000 young Americans into the shooting sports for safe, proper legal gun handling. That drives the enemy berserk. That's how you cleanse your soul while you're winning the war, having the time of your life.
No, you're right. We all need to fight hard and then play hard. The Black Power Tour, in closing, tell us about that. That really upset the system that your inspiration was black rock and rollers. It also upsets them that Charlton Heston was such a humanitarian in the civil rights movement.
Well, all the good music in the world comes from black artists, from the Howlin' Wolf and Muddy Waters into Bo Diddley and Chuck Berry and Little Richard and James Brown and Wilson Pickett and Sam and Dave and the Motown Funk Brothers. So my incredible band, the greatest rock and roll rhythm and blues band in the world, Greg Smith and Mick Brown and Derek St. Holmes, we're hitting the road this year, starting next month with REO and Styx. Then we're going out all summer before the hunting season starts. But we're going to play a tribute, as we always have for 50 years, to those black American heroes that have inspired every piece of killer music in the history of mankind. And it's called Black Power because the black artists showed us the way musically and emotionally, and that spirit and the uppity ferocity. So we should take that and use it. You can use Stranglehold as the ultimate soundtrack for freedom and defiance. And I want to thank everybody for making our Spirit of the Wild show the number one show on Outdoor Channel, and our Wanted Ted or Alive show the number one show on Sportsman Channel. But I'm keeping at it. I'm turning up the heat, and we need to get more aggressive and need to win this culture war ASAP.
Well, look at how all these hit shows on Discovery, they're trying to cancel them, even though they're hits, because they know we're winning the culture war. I see this whole attack as desperate flailing.
It is desperate flailing, but that's going to backfire on Jim Carrey's going to backfire. Michael Moore's backfiring. I believe, Nancy, you don't need to read this. You need to sign it. Pelosi is a backfire in itself. So we need to take advantage of the indecency, the hate from the other side. We need to express it. Always express it calmly. If you're going to call your senator, have a piece of paper with the main 2 points you want to make.
Absolutely. TedNugent.com. Ted, thank you for giving such an eloquent defense of Charlton Heston. Not that he needed it, you're right, but God bless you, and we'll talk to you again very soon. Folks, Ted Nugent.
Godspeed, Alex.
You too. Goodbye. Visit InfoWars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. When you're on the site, you can also tune in 24 hours a day to my daily radio broadcast. There's also a free iPhone app to listen to the syndicated radio show when and where you want.
Someone being the best that they can be. People who appreciate the gift of life, the sacred gift of life, and our moral, intellectual, and spiritual obligation to defend that life, and that the Second Amendment was written down to remind us we have the individual God-given right to defend that precious gift of life. Good people understand the pure rot from Jim Carrey. So, in his grave, Alex, let's really examine this. From the grave, the great Charlton Heston represents bait to the Jim Carreys of the world. And I think Charlton Heston, if we could communicate with him, he would be smiling right now. He wouldn't be hurt. He would be smiling because Charlton Heston knew the culture war was coming before any of us did, Alex.
No, he was there sounding He was there sounding the alarm, and he is, just like our forebears fight from the grave for liberty with their statements and the Second Amendment they laid down, Charlton Heston is, like an El Cid, strapped dead on the horse, out there terrifying the enemy.
Yep, and here's the beauty. Charlton Heston would be more than proud to cause much anguish and insanity in the soulless vacuum of Jim Carrey's brain. I always appreciate it, but a salute back at you, because there's no question that the great American legend and icon, a true warrior, a true hero, Charlton Heston, deserves nothing but respect from thinking, caring, conscientious, educated people. But again, as we talked before about the gift from God that Piers Morgan represents, I mean, God literally sent Piers Morgan from England to try to debate the Second Amendment. So you literally couldn't come up with Alfred E. Newman versus an audition for One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest to come up with a better representative of a guy who hates freedom and hates the Second Amendment and hates Ted Nugent, Alex Jones, and hates the NRA and hates self-defense and hates guns. And I think we are not here so much to defend Charlton Heston, because once again, God has sent a complete brain-dead, soulless punk to desecrate the absolutely well-earned and deserved glowing reputation of the great Charlton Heston. And what Jim Carrey has done, and I've been all over, we have a talk back at tednugent.com, and we have thousands of people from all around the world that come to celebrate self-evident truth and common sense. You know, the same communication that you get, Alex, from people who understand, you know, history, the evidence that brought us to the greatest experience and the greatest quality of life in America. And when a guy like Jim Carrey...
Out. Now, I called... A very busy individual, but he's obviously very angry about what's happening as well. I talked to him this morning on his cell phone, Ted Nugent, who needs no introduction, NRA board member, you know, top rock and roller, patriot, hunter. I called him on his cell phone a couple hours ago, and I said, can you come on about Charlton Heston? I know you were very good friends with him and really got him to get more hardcore on the Second Amendment. He said, absolutely. It was Ted Nugent that helped supercharge Charlton Heston into the fight at many levels. So here is his friend to defend Chuck, Charlton Heston, because he can't do it. He's dead. But again, Charlton Heston will live forever as long as liberty lives. And so understand that, ladies and gentlemen, this is a big deal when people literally desecrate the grave of a man who would do 50 plus interviews a week when he was almost 80 years old, and who would travel the country for nothing, no money, to defend the Second Amendment. And I knew him. I had a chance to talk to him off air. He was the real deal and probably the classiest person I've ever had the pleasure to get to know a little bit. And I'll be honest, I don't envy many things. I envy Ted Nugent being such good friends with him. Ted, you've got the floor, my friend. You've got the floor. Thank you for coming on TedNugent.com. I know you're about to go on your Black Power tour, and but we appreciate you giving us time today. Sir, you've got the floor.
It pulls off this kind of mean-spirited, soulless, I think the best word to describe Jim Carrey and Piers Morgan and guys like, you know, Michael, I'm still looking for personal hygiene more. They're all one big gaggle of soulless punks. And I would understand, and I understand when a person is uneducated and ignorant and hates America and hates self-defense and doesn't believe in self-defense, but then again, if you examine Michael Moore and his armed security detail, if you examine Jim Carrey and his armed security detail, when you examine Michael Bloomberg and Governor Cuomo and Nancy, you don't have to read this, you need to sign it, Pelosi, and of course our favorite gun runner, Eric Holder, when you examine the freedom haters who hate guns and want to do everything on film, stating clearly they would take away all the guns if they could. These people are perfect to represent the other side, because when they open their mouth, yes, we have an unfortunate and a tragic percentage of Americans who are more like sheep than we the people that support these freedom haters. When they speak, common sense America, people who have jobs, people who put their heart and soul.
Last night it was in some of the establishment prostitute media, the dinosaur media, praising Jim Carrey. I've seen him in interviews. I mean, I think he genuinely is mentally ill. He's kind of a geek. That's why it's funny to watch him. Literally denigrate and in this disgusting five-minute song, and we're going to go over some of the lyrics to it here today, and it's got some profanity, so we won't play all of it. Say that gun owners, but that Chuck Heston, Charlton Heston, a true humanitarian, a true civil rights activist, a patriot, that he is guilty for dead kids, that he won't be going to heaven, and that he's mentally ill and believes in space aliens. And it was just so ham-fisted and so pathetic, I got angry, and I figured it out last night. I couldn't even go to sleep, folks, and I can go to sleep in like 1 minute. I can just turn my brain off. I was so upset I couldn't go to bed till like 2 in the morning. I shot like 3 videos for the YouTube channel because I realized these people are so pathetic and such liars and such hypocrites with their bodyguards and so anti-individual and so wrong and so authoritarian that I'm angry that we have not routed them